Let's go.
You ready?
Good.
Joined here by Steve Radder, coach of the Gold Coast Knights. Stevie, point gained or two dropped?
Two dropped. They are very happy with that, mate. They got out of jail. We are naive. You know, we're a young side. You know, we went into the break, you know, completely dominated, and then to come out, and we knew they had to go for the game. They had to go for it, and we knew what they were going to do. We anticipated it. The guys just, they weren't switched on. Just shocking, absolutely shocking.
On a positive, I guess it's nice to be on your own park for a week.
Yes, it is. We hopefully, you know, we're away next week, but then we're about eight games, I think, straight at home. So, you know, the weather's been kind to us now for the last week, and hopefully we get a good session next week, Tuesday and Thursday. And look forward to a game against Port, I believe.
Woolloombar at home, I think it is, but we'll sort that out. Because you were trying to change something. But back on today's game, you got 4-1 up, and what is it, just the youthfulness, or is it complacency, or what was it? I mean, it was 3-1, 3-0, then 4-1. So
we work so hard to create goals, and we're just still very naive at the back. We just, you know, it's just too much ball watching. You know, I can't say much more to that. We have to work on it this week, and hopefully we start to stop these leaks. Because we can certainly score, but you're not going to win games if you concede that many as well.
Bit of a discipline issue there right at the end, so you'll be without Slidey next week by the look of things. So can you fill us in what happened there? Or?
I'm not sure. I believe he said something to the ref because it was supposed to be a corner.
Blew full time?
Yeah, it blew full time in frustration. Obviously, it wasn't probably a nice, kind word to the ref, and I think it was two yellows.
No, it was a straight red.
Was it? Oh, there you go. There you go. So, well, just keep going.
Woolloombar next week, top of the table, unbeaten. They had another win on the weekend, so you go down there without the top goal scorer. How do you face that one then?
Oh, we're going to go the same way. We're just going to keep playing an attacking formation football, and I enjoy it, and the players enjoy it, but we've got to work on our defensive, our defenders, and hopefully we'll sort that out.
So you've played Burley twice now, 3-all, 4-all, 7-all, so is it more concerning that you're conceding 7 goals, or more pleasing that you've scored 7 against them?
Oh, look, I'm always happy to score goals, but again, today I feel really disappointed, and I don't know what Philo mentioned, but they were very lucky today, very lucky.
Well, Philo said that 4-1 they were lucky, but at 4-all they felt unlucky that they didn't get all 3. So,
well, we could have done the same.
So. Yeah, look, mate, good luck. Thanks for your time. Good luck next week, and see you around the roundabout.
Thanks, gents.
Cheers, buddy.
Go for it.
Joined here by Burley Heads coach Cole Phelan. Philo, a bit of a tough week for the club this week. What happened off the park? You think it's sort of a bit of a late start on the park? Any effect?
No, not really. I mean, obviously, you know, a lot of lads aren't in the best frame of mind. You know, obviously, losing young Galliot, you know what I mean? It was been a big part of this club for years, and he's a fantastic kid, you know, and it's a massive loss for a lot of us who've had a lot to do with Burley, and certainly, you know, his dad, who's put a lot of mileage in for the club. And to be honest, you know, it's a tough time, you know, like, I think we take things out of perspective, you know what I mean? We threw a game of football today and dropped 2 points. You know, his mum and dad are sitting in the house, devastated, you know what I mean? As we all are, you know what I mean? So, you know, it's been a tough week. There's no thing, but no excuses, you know what I mean? You know, like, it took us another probably half an hour to get going again today, and that's been a bit of a story. So, to be fair, you know, like, I'm obviously very unhappy about the result, but, you know, at 4-1, you're obviously going to take that. But we can't keep on doing this week in, week out, you know what I mean?
Well, you're 2 weeks in a row now. You've conceded 7, a bit concerning, but you've also, on a positive side, you've scored 7. So is it a plus or a minus, I guess?
Yeah, no, but I mean, it is concerning. But, you know, like, you know, we're forever looking for positives, and one of them is we're still unbeaten. You know what I mean? Like, if it would have been years ago when it was 2 points, we'd be top of the league now, you know?
That's going back a long way, Philo.
Well, there's not many of us remember that. But to be fair, no, you know, like, we have it, something we've got to work on, and we did try and address the problem, but, you know, to be fair, I mean, the third goal the boy scored for the Knights was a different clash, you know what I mean?
The volley.
Yeah, and to be honest, we're our own worst enemy at times. And to be fair, it's because we try and play football all the time, and we're going to make mistakes, but we will not start lumping long balls, you know what I mean?
No, look, 2 weeks in a row, but Phil, the pleasing aspect, I think you were 3-1 down in the 90th minute last week. You were 4-1 down after about 35, and you fought back both times. So there's some spirit in the team.
Well, that's what I mean. I just said to the players, I said, you know, you've got to take a lot of credit for, like, coming away with a point. You know, like, we know 3-1's at March, a little bit of a mountain, 4-1, it's massive, you know. And but to be fair, you know, we've done enough to win it in the end.
Yep.
And I think we deserve to win it, you know. Like, Daniel's had a great chance on the end. There was some decisions weren't the best in the top third, but, mate, you know, we just got to get up there.
You
know?
Like you said, football's one thing, there's other things going on, so
yeah,
thanks.
Yeah, mate, this is what we all do for fun. And I'm the world's worst, you know, like, it affects me, you know what I mean, but... That's the way I am, you know. I love
you wake
football,
up in the morning.
But, you know, at the end of the day, I think this week it's about other people, you know what I mean?
Well, thanks for your time, mate. Good luck next week, and see you at the end of the year, hopefully.
Okay, thank you.